Very good morning to all my dear students. Welcome to St. Andrew's Public School Bagpat online economics classes part 1 work from home. Today we will discuss chapter number 4 measurement of national income, which is from macroeconomics book. As you know that weightage of chapter number 3 and chapter number 4 is 10 marks. In 10 marks, or as you know that we have already discussed chapter number 3 in a best way. Now we are going to study chapter number 4 measurement of national income in also a best way. So listen carefully. I hope you will try to give your best. See here. National income. National income of a country. National can be written as NNPHFC, and you know the meaning of NNPHFC. So see carefully. National income of a country can be measured by three different methods. So there are three different methods to calculate national income. First method is value added method. Second is income method. Third is expenditure method. And I would like to tell you one important thing is that either you are calculating national income with the help of value added method, with the help of income method, with the help of expenditure method, you will get the same value of national income. What I'm saying that either you are calculating national income with the help of value added method, with the help of income method, with the help of expenditure method, you will get the same value of national income. Why I'm saying this? Listen carefully. Note, it must be noted that all the three methods give the same value of national income. As you know that we have already discussed this. Like, because they are used to measure the same physical output at three different phases. Listen carefully. Either you are calculating national income by value added method, you will measure physical output, same physical output. Either you are calculating income method, you will measure same physical output. Either you are calculating national income by expenditure method, you will measure same physical output. So value of same physical output will remain same. So according to this, if value of same physical output will remain same, then it means that either you are calculating national income by value added method, income method, or expenditure method, you will get the same value of national income, because all these methods will measure same physical output at three different phases means primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. Understood? Next, now we are going to study first method, value added method. See carefully. Under this method, national income is measured by adding the contribution. Under this method, national income is measured by adding the contribution. What is the meaning of contribution? Value added by each and every producing unit. Producing unit means primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector in the production process during an accounting year. During an accounting year, during a given period of time, fiscal year, financial year, all these are same. From 1st April to 31st March. So this is the definition of value added method. Under this method, national income is measured by adding the contribution, means value added by each and every producing unit in the production process during an accounting year. We can say, in other words, listen carefully. We can say that if we want to calculate national income under value added method, then we have to add the contribution by each and every producing unit. And producing units are classified in three categories. First is primary units, second is secondary units, and third is tertiary units. So I hope all of you have understood this. What is the meaning of value added method? All of you have understood this. See, after this, note, value added method is also known as product method, इन्वेंट्री मेथड, नेट आउटपुट मेथड, इंडस्ट्रियल ओरिजिन मेथड, कॉमोडिटी सर्विस मेथड एट्सेट्रा. ऑल दीज आर अदर नेम ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड मेथड. ऑल दीज आर अदर नेम ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड मेथड. सो रिमेंबर दिस, ऑल रिमेंबर ऑल दीज अदर नेम ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड मेथड. आई होप ऑल यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड मेथड एंड द अदर नेम ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड मेथड. नाउ दिस इज क्लियर. नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू एडेड. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक अबाउट value added. Value added means contribution. What is the meaning of value added? See carefully. Value added refers to the addition of value. Value added refers to the addition of value to the raw material. To the raw material. What is the meaning of raw material? Intermediate goods by a firm by its productive activities in an accounting year. In an accounting year. So, I am saying this, what is the meaning of value added? Value added refers to the addition of value. Addition of value to the raw material by a firm, by its productive activities in an accounting year. We can say in other words also, listen carefully. Value added method refers to the value added. We can say addition of value to the raw material or intermediate goods by a firm by its productive activities in an accounting year. So this is the definition of value added. Listen carefully. Definition of value added method is different from the definition of value added. Value added method is different meaning and value added meaning of is different. I hope all of you have understood this. So I hope all of you have understood the meaning of value added method, other name of value added method and meaning of value added. What is the meaning of value added? Value added refers to the addition of value to the intermediate goods or raw material by a firm by its productive activities in an accounting year. Now come to the next point. See here, steps of value added method. Steps of value added method. What are the steps? Suppose question is there. Explain the steps of value added method to calculate national income. What is question? Explain the steps of value added method to calculate national income. So what will be the steps? See here. Step 1. Identification and classification of production units. Identification and classification of production units. How many types of production units? There are 3 production units. First is primary units, second is secondary, third is tertiary. See here. First of all, you will identify and then after you will classify of production units of an economy into primary units, secondary units, and tertiary units, or we can say tertiary sector. So I hope this is the first step. Firstly you will identify, then after you will classify of production units into primary units, secondary units and tertiary units. I hope step one is clear. See step second. Estimation of gross value added at market price. We can say right in short form GVA at MP. GVA at MP. And you all of you know that other name of you can say that GVA at MP is known as GDP at MP. GVA at MP is known as GDP at MP. And I hope all of you know the meaning of GDP at MP. If you know the meaning of GDP at MP, then you will definitely know the meaning of gross value added at market price. How can we calculate GV at MP? See here, gross value added at market price. We can see here GV at MP equal to value of output minus value of input. Value of output minus value of input. वैल्यू ऑफ इनपुट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इंटरमीडिएट कंजम्पशन, इंटरमीडिएट कंजम्पशन, इंटरमीडिएट कंजम्पशन. सी हियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट. इट रेफर्स टू मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ, इट रेफर्स टू मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल फाइनल गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यूरिंग ए पीरियड ऑफ वन ईयर. सो नाउ ऑल इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट, यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट इन सिंपल टर्म्स. प्लीज रिमाइंड दिस, प्लीज ट्राई टू स्पीक दिस. इट रेफर्स टू मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ, यू नो द मार्केट वैल्यू एंड यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ मार्केट वैल्यू बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन चैप्टर नंबर 3 व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मार्केट वैल्यू. मार्केट वैल्यू रेफर्स टू दैट प्राइस एट विच प्रोडक्ट इज एक्चुअली सोल्ड इन द मार्केट, प्रोडक्ट इज एक्चुअली सोल्ड इन द मार्केट. सो सी हियर इट रेफर्स टू मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल फाइनल गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यूरिंग ए पीरियड ऑफ वन ईयर. सो आई होप ऑल यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस. नाउ सी हियर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट, यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट. एंड नाउ सी हियर हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट. वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट इज इक्वल टू सेल्स प्लस चेंज इन स्टॉक. What is the formula of change in stock? Closing stock minus opening stock plus production for self-consumption. Suppose I have manufactured 100 shirts. How many shirts? 100 shirts. Suppose I have sold 50 shirts in the market. I have sold 50 shirts in the market. And after this, I have used 20 shirts for on self consumption. Now 50 shirts are sold out in the market and 20 shirts are used for on consumptions, and how many shirts remain unsold? 50 plus 20 is equal to 70 minus 100. Now 30 shirts will remain unsold. 30 shirts will remain unsold. Those 30 shirts which are unsold, known as change in stock, will be counted as change in stock. So I hope all of you have clear this. See after this. Sales, if sales is not given directly in your question, so how can we calculate? See, sales equal to price into quantity produced. Price will be given and number of units produced will also be given. So now multiply both of these, then you will get the value of sales. Now another formula of sales is sales equal to domestic sales plus export. Domestic sales means